Ladies and gentlemen, I ought to present one little unusual presentation, which includes my photographs of art works of cultural and art investment, also my painting, sculptures and installation. You also will see several uncolored photographs which I have made 30 years ago. The photos are made during my first visit here in Berlin. Enjoy watching. In the last couple of decades, the economic contribution of cultural, creative, entertainment and tourist industries in the member states of the European Union has been a complex process and in relation to the new cycle of industrial development, as well as in a very clear interdisciplinary connection with other services and production processes in the romantic sectors. In this sense, they have been perceived as a catalyst of intelligent and innovative alternatives in the manufacturing and service sector. Furthermore, the cultural and creative sectors take a serious place in the Europe 2020 strategy for the contribute to a new type of sustainable and cohesive social growth in the EU as a counteraction to the social and economic crisis. The significance of the strategy has been outlined in the encouragement of the contribution of cultural and creative industry in its three priorities because their role can be recognized and timely interwoven into the future economic and political tools at the level of EU member states. A serious step toward this has been the published by the European Commission Green Book on the potential of these industries, product of the efforts of institutions, experts, as organization of the civil society. It raises to a new stage the debate of developing creativity and innovation in Europe by looking at if from the point of entrepreneurial training and partnership relation, drawing upon the thesis that only two practical realization of this mutual model whose philosophy is based on more entrepreneurial spirit in art and creativity and more creativity and art in entrepreneurship can the EU successfully follow the priorities in the strategy in question in the area of the intelligent, stable and cohesive growth. for the purposes is necessary to study well at the national and local level the cultural, creative, educational, entertainment and tourist resources. Starting from this strategy could be drawn based on solid methodology for studying and analysis of cultural assets, so they could promise of the cultural, creative, cultural and entertainment industries. The strategy could comprise a map of the existing capacities of the cultural, artistic, education and entertainment infrastructures for the development of culture, arts, cultural and creative industries, cultural tourism, human cultural education and creative capital assets. The thematic cultural education and entertainment products and services, especially those that are innovative and variety in the nature, require a strong visionary strategy to legitimize their presence on the market. Creating a strategy for branding, visual branding systems, and identification of participants in the creation of the same cultural education and entertainment products will create a strong communication with the various societal cultural communities. This is at the heart of functioning of various innovative models for branding these products in the fields of cultural arts, education, cultural and art tourism, cultural and entertainment industries, as well as strong branded messages to social and geo-social networks. Brought traditional online and mobile services. The participation of students, teenagers, young people, and other target groups at all level of education in competitions, exhibition, symposium, festivals, workshops, BNRs, and other traditional and innovative cultural and art events, as well creating visually plastic representative models of national and literary heroes and famous historical figures and their exposure to the different culture and art spaces during these events will lead to new models of aesthetic, moral, patriotic, social, emotional and physical behavior. Similar festivals, celebration and competitions dedicated to the arts and culture can be oriented exclusively to invest related to schools and education to encourage students to participate in art competition context and competition and stimulated them to participate in didactic to arts and culture activities, both during their free time and during school hours at school. These events can not be limited to opportunities to demonstrate knowledge and skill closely related to arts and culture, but also take the form of literature, theater, music, workshops, competition or sports events. Many programs can be developed that grant scholarships to children who show excellence in national and international competition, festivals, and art activities. At national level, the creation of a new management and organization structure could be initiated under the auspice of several wards, ministries to organize, conduct and manage a variety of traditional and innovative cultural activities in the form of special days or weeks, competition and events. At regional level, such structures may be involved in organizing and conducting the Chor Festival, exhibition of paintings, graphics, illustration, fine art, graphs, dance, theaters and song festival, etc. Cultural times could be held in order to familiarize the participants in education, cultural and entertainment processes with the empirical importance of arts and culture, thus strengthening the links between art, education and entertainment. They could include all visual and plastic arts, contemporary art, dance, music, poetry, prose, cinema, Chinese shadow theater, etc. Within these events, training course could be organized for teachers of arts, museum, workers and specialty, cultural and art angels, gallery owners, tour operators, and so on. Within the framework of education, cultural and entertainment processes is necessary that all parties involved should be encouraged to participate in arts and cultural events, celebration, World Day of Youth activities, etc. at local, national and international level. They can also include creative workshops and events dedicated to the arts in the fields of architecture, design, fine arts, performing arts, free creativity, drawing and painting, portrait, mastery, journalism, iconography and popular art, sports, games, multimedia, modeling, theater, movies. At the same time, song and instrumental recitals dance performance, plays marionette and puppet shows for children, film screenings, riding on roller skates and sports demonstration would be organized. Using ICT in extra curricular forms of education in arts and culture and the implementation of different initiatives for the support of such education on the basis of constructing and development of local, national, and international organization and networks within versatile cultural and entertainment environment is related to project development in art and culture, lifelong learning, and it includes studying media art as part of the intertrade view on audiovisual education based on a gradual vertical and horizontal approaches. The former starts from the first year at kindergarten and finishes in the last year if secondary education. Here is the letter comprise of subjects from the curriculum, courses, target groups, and age borders. This should be in accord with the final outcomes and the aims of such education. The boys on base, the use of new multimedia technology and interdisciplinary approaches trainees will be able to get acquainted with the basis principles of network culture, the most common sense and symbol of visual communication and information. It is also necessary to provide service, support and information to all participants in educational, cultural and entertainment processes for the use of ICT in the art and cultural lifelong learning. ICT-based education programs should be developed and established based on the use of innovative multimedia education resources for students and teachers and other enterprise parties on the basis of developed interactive e-context multidisciplinary individual plans. Assessment should be made of the cultural impact of cultural entertainment and education initiative aiming to improve their effective use. This would give the trainers and the trainees opportunities to actively participate in the education of understand of art and cultural at local, national and international level. Thus, participants in this process could acquire knowledge, skills and key competencies in the perception of artistic and cultural heritage using ICT. Assisted by qualified representative from museums and institutions in the fields of arts, cultural and cultural arts, entertainment and tourism industry. All of them could actively participate in the collection and preparation of the required content for the subsequent publication of e-indication resource in social networks on the internet in different languages. Dear audience, we will be very happy to answer of your question, but yes, my English is not good, please. Write them down and send them to me. Send, I will answer them. Thank you.
Thank you very much, dear professor, too. Now, do you have questions? Yes, I'm coming.
Hello, my name is Adam. I'm from Prague, the Czech Republic. Thank you for your presentation. I think your photos are very inspiring and stimulating. I wanted to ask you one question. Do you think that Bulgaria is good at promoting the culture? What do you think?
No, no, go to the podium. To the podium.
За голямо съжаление, били, да, били правил. За голямо съжаление, България не е от сред добрите примери за отношение към изкуството, за неговото използване като ресурс за развитието на туризма.
Unfortunately, the opinion of Professor Velev is that Bulgaria is not a good example in promoting our Bulgarian culture and art as a tool of nation branding.
Нашия университет работи активно за промотиране на различни политики, които са свързани с усвояването на добрите световни практики, но пък и такива, които ние бихме могли да извлечем от нашия недългодишен опит в сферата на културата и на туризма. Да.
The good news is that the university where the Professor Velev work at is currently involved with many different projects, international projects, and they are already started to adapt the best world practices in cultural and art promotion. And of course, they use their rich experience in culture, in cultural promotion and preservation in Bulgaria, and would like to would like to extend this practice for the future.
В презентацията не случайно имаше така произведение на световни автори. И мои. И по отношение на изкуството не отстъпваме, но по отношение на политиките може би трябва да догонваме западните наши приятели.
Professor Velev chose to make his presentation as combination between his artworks and world famous art pieces as example that the best practices is the combination between experience that we have and that for the future they would like to develop the, exactly this project that can promote Bulgarian art and culture.
Между прочим, тези последните творби са от Венецианското биенале. Биеналето в Венеция, миналата година, 56-то издание.
His piece arts are from Venice Biennale, the last... Yes, the last art biennale in Venice, 2015. Do you have any questions? Yes?
Hello, sir. My name is Hilman. I'm from Indonesia. First of all, I would like to say your presentation was so refreshing. It was so good. Okay, I would like to know who is your biggest inspirations and what inspires you of doing your thing. Thank you.
Кое е вашето най-голямо вдъхновение и кое ви вдъхновява да работите?
Всичко добро. Което ни заобикаля и красиво е моето вдъхновение, но всичко, което ни провокира и предизвиква, е също такъв голям мотив да творя.
My inspiration is everything beautiful, everything good in this world. And on the other hand, also everything which provoke us, which give us not so good examples, but also this is a good inspiration for work.
Thank you.